Hello everyone, this section of information is about the microbes which are acting as a biocontrol agents. So why we need to have microbes for biocontrol agents? Let's understand this topic. What is the basic significance of microorganisms in controlling the biological agents? So biocontrol basically refers to the use of biological methods for controlling plant diseases and pests. In the modern society, these problems have been tackled increasingly by using the chemicals, by use of insecticides, pesticides. These chemicals basically they are toxic and very harmful to the human beings and animals in a similar way, and have been polluting to the environment either in the form of soil pollution or you can say ground pollution, water pollution. So most of these chemicals, they ultimately affects the and degrade the quality of fruits, vegetable and crop plants. Our soil is also polluted through the use of the weedicides which are used to remove such unwanted plants from the cropping field or cropped areas. So let's see what are the different types of biological agents which are used for controlling the pest and diseases which are very much prevalent among the cropping plants. So in case of agriculture, there is basically a method of controlling pest that relies on the natural predation rather than introduction of the chemicals. So the key belief to the organic farmer is that biodiversity furthers the health of the plant. So the more variety a landscape is having, the more sustainable it is. So the organic farmer therefore works to create a system where the insects that are sometimes called as pest are not eradicated. So, but instead they are kept at manageable levels by a complex system of checks and balances within a living and vibrant ecosystem. So, in contrast to this, the conventional farming practices which often use chemical methods to kill both useful and harmful life forms is now being abolished, and this is a holistic approach that seeks to develop an understanding of the webs of interaction between the different organisms that constitute the field of fauna and flora. So the organic farmer basically holds the view that the eradication of the creatures that are often described as pest is not only possible but also undesirable. For without them, the beneficial predatory and parasitic insects which depend upon them as a food, or for the host which would not be able to survive. So the use of biocontrol agents or biocontrol measures will greatly reduce our dependence on the toxic chemicals and pesticides. So the important part of biological farming approach is become nowadays familiar with the various life forms that inhabit the field. So predators as well as pests, and also their life cycles, pattern of feeding and the habitat that they prefer. This will help to develop appropriate means of biocontrol. So most of the bacteria, fungi, viruses can all act as a biocontrol agents due to the large diversity of the target species and the variety of methods of action. The important examples of microbial biological control agents are basically the bacterial species like Bacillus thuringiensis, fluorescent Pseudomonas and Bulgaria bassinia. The next important, you can say, the integrated pest management program, which is also known as IPM, which is also known as integrated pest control, is a broad methodology which is basically integrates the practice for the economic control of pest. So IPM basically aims to suppress the pest population below the economic injury level. As you know that in food chain, when we are going to we can say if any of the organism from one of the trophic level is, if it is being depleted from the nature, you know that entire food chain it suffers. So that's why they are controlling the pest population below the economic injury level. They mean to say this one only, that IEIL, it means the same, that food chain, and without disturbing the food chain and food web, they used to control these biological agents by the other biological means. So the United Nations Food and Agricultural Organization basically defines the integrated pest management as the careful consideration of all available pest control techniques and subsequent integration of appropriate measures that discourage the development of pest population and keeps the pesticides and other intervention to the level that are economically justified and reduced or minimize the risk of human health and the environment. So integrated pest management emphasizes the growth of a healthy crop with the least possible disruption. It means the disturbance to the entire ecosystem, to the agro ecosystem, and encourages the natural pest control mechanism. So we have very much familiarity with the different type of organisms which are being also mentioned in your textbook, and one such example is you are seeing here in the form of a ladybird bug, which is a beetle, which basically these ladybird are the insects, and they are considered as a beneficial bug which helps in getting rid of the area of crop damage which are caused by the aphids, mealybugs and other destructive insect pests. The adult ladybugs feed on these insects. They may also lay their eggs among the aphids or other prey so that the emerging larvae can feed on the insects too. So this insect is acting as a biocontrol agent in maintaining the ecosystem, or you can say organic farming, and it ultimately controls the growth of the other harmful organisms which are destroying the crops grown in a particular area or field. Likewise, we have the another example of the insect, and it is dragonfly. Since dragonflies eats the mosquito and other insects, they help the gardeners and outdoor enthusiasts. So this also helps the environment because it allows the human to reduce the use of pesticides to kill these insects. So as we know that biomagnification is a broad term in which you must have learned in your previous classes also, that whenever there is use of chemicals in the nature, either in the form of pesticides or insecticides, weedicides, whatever be the form, to kill or to eradicate these organisms from whatever be the purpose we are having, or to get reduce the harmful effects they cause to the environment. So after application of these chemicals, what happens? The chemical concentration it goes on increasing, and it magnifies from one trophic level to another trophic level. And one such example you have already studied in the 10th class regarding the DDT. So these organisms, they basically helps to get down the reduction, or you can say they used to lower down the use of chemicals. So unnecessarily use of these chemicals can be avoided by using such organisms. So how beautiful and how interesting is this concept, that we are not using such chemicals to destroy our ecological system or to pollute the environment, either in the form of soil pollution, water pollution. So Such example also carries one of the important organism, and this one is Bacillus thuringiensis. You can see the electron microscopic picture of this organism. So the strains of this bacterium, that is Bacillus thuringiensis, produce over 200 different types of Bt toxin. So Bt toxin is basically the chemical which is being released by these organisms, and these chemicals, they are harmful to the different insects which are feeding on the crops which are grown in the fields. So how this organism is basically used for protecting the crops and the to increase the yield of the farmers and to maintain the economic health of the plants and also the economic balance of the farmers. So when we use these organisms, what happens? Most of the notably Bt toxins, they are acting as an insecticidal to the larvae of the moths or the insect which are feeding over the crops, and butterflies, beetles. So these cotton bollworms and gutu flies, they are harmless to other forms of the life. The gene coding for the Bt toxin has been inserted into the cotton. So the Bt toxin gene is being introduced into the cotton plant as a transgenic or a transgenic plant, and that's why the cotton name has Bt cotton. So why that particular species of cotton is named as Bt cotton? Because of the introduction of the gene which is being taken from the microbial agent, and that agent is basically the bacteria Bacillus thuringiensis. So that particular gene which is producing the insecticide is being now transferred to the plant itself. Now what happens? The gene which is coding for the Bt toxin has been inserted, and it acts as a transgene, causing it to produce this natural insecticides in its tissue. So in many regions, the main pest in commercial cotton are Lepidopteran larvae, which are killed by the Bt protein in the genetically modified cotton when they eat such plants. That is, when the insect is coming and hovering over the plant, and when it starts eating the leaves, or you can say the fruits of the plant, what will happen? The Bt toxin present in the plant itself will act as an insecticide, and it will help to destroy the biological predator. And ultimately, without using any insecticide over the plants, we are able to save our plant species. So this basically eliminates the need to use large amount of broad. This eliminates the need of use of large amounts of broad spectrum insecticides to kill Lepidopteran pest, some of which have been developed pre-thyroid resistance. So this spares the natural insect predators in the farm ecology and further contributes the non-insecticide pest management. So it's beneficial for the farmers to use such type of genetically modified seeds of the Bt cotton. Likewise, we have the another organism, that is a fungal, fungal in origin, and that is Trichoderma species. You can see the picture of the fungus over here. Now this Trichoderma species basically promotes the growth of plants and limits the growth of plant pathogens. So Trichoderma species are effective fungicides, biofungicides, enzymatically they are degrading other fungi, producing antimicrobial compound that kill pathogenic fungi and out-competing pathogenic fungi for space and nutrients. So this is also helping the farmers, and you can say the nature directly by introducing such chemicals that ultimately stops the growth of other agents around that particular area where it grows. Likewise, we have the example of the viruses also, which are also acting as a agents to control the you can say pest. Now you can see here the picture of the baculoviruses at the resolution of 100 nanometers. These viruses altogether, they are known as baculoviridae. So baculoviruses are basically the pathogens that attack the insects and other arthropods. The majority of the baculoviruses are used as a biocontrol agents in the form of a genus that is known as nucleopolyhedroviruses. So baculoviruses or viruses will hereafter refer to as nucleopolyhedroviruses. So this is all about the different sort of organisms. You need to retain the actual name of these organisms and their correlation to save the environment, to save the crops, and how they are able to manifest and control the different other set of organisms, that is the biological agents which are harming these crops, and the on application of these organisms over these crops, organic farmers, they are getting the benefit economically and ultimately saving the environment, which is basically the helpful for the both human beings, because we are also acting as a part, or we are also belonging to this ecological system. So this is all about the microbial role with respect to the biocontrol, and these microorganisms, they are acting as a biocontrol agents.